Now moving on to our fourth section, and we'll be discussing thoracic outlet syndrome in this. We're briefly going what is a glad summer type of neurogenic thoracic outlet syndrome and what is glad summer type hand. We'll be briefly going how to diagnose thoracic outlet syndrome, especially when we are dealing with, because there's multiple causes which are causing the thoracic outlet syndrome, and then how to do the surgical decompression, because it mainly affects the lower plexus, that is C8T1 mainly. Therefore, what are the surgical mechanism by which we can relieve the nerve compression, especially of the ulnar nerve, in associated with the thoracic outlet syndrome. Thoracic outlet syndrome, it could be due to multiple other causes. One of the most common causes is actually the subclavian vessel syndrome. That is usually when they pass just below the clavicle, there is abnormality of the subclavian vessels by which they can compress the lower nerve roots of the brachial plexus, that is the C8 and T1. Other causes could be subclavian lower trunk of the brachial plexus mainly, that is, and subclavian vessels. Usually we know that the brachial plexus starts from C5 to TA1, that is C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. But it actually enters into the axilla between the scalene anterior and scalene medius muscle. So if there is any nerve which is actually compressing these two muscles, or for example this hypertrophy of scalene muscles, or there could be congenital aberrant muscles which can be present between the scalene anterior and medius, then this can also compress the brachial plexus over there, leading to thoracic outlet syndrome. So there could be anomalous scalene muscle, I just told you, between the scalene anterior scalene muscle medius. Therefore, it can lead to thoracic outlet syndrome. Or there could be, usually it's mainly C8, the T1, which is actually compressed. And therefore, it's mainly showing the ulnar nerve neuropathy. That is, there is sensory changes in the ulnar 1.5 fingers, that is the little finger, and ulnar side of the ring finger, mainly in the hypothenar region of the hand and wrist joint, and as well as the forearm, medial side of the forearm and medial side of the arm, maybe a numb, or there may be sensory changes over there because C8T1 is mainly involved. Coming to what is glad summer type neurogenic thoracic outlet syndrome. This is actually associated with wasting of hypothenar eminence and forearm musculature. Mainly the C8T1 is actually compromised, and this results is also called the formation of glad summer type neurogenic hand. That is due to this wasting of hypothenar. There is actually cloying is also less common, although there is maybe some degree of cloying as well. But usually the ulnar neuropathy is associated with thoracic outlet syndrome. There could be lumen contraction, or there could be emboli formation, cyanosis and thrombosis, edema of the mainly the little and the ring finger. This all the symptoms are of the ulnar nerve compression syndrome, but the problem is not in the ulnar nerve, but the problem is higher up in the neck, that is resulting due to thoracic outlet syndrome. Usually it's due to subclavian artery which gets actually really compressed. Clinical features include pain and paresthesia. I just told you, mean the C8T1 dermatome is involved, that is medial side of the arm, medial side of the forearm, hypothenar side of the palm, and the ulnar 1.5 fingers. There is mild cloying, as with the ulnar paradox, that the higher the lesion is, there will be less cloying. The lower the lesion is, in case of ulnar nerve, there will be increased cloying. There is a wasting and weakness of intrinsic muscle because the ulnar nerve is mainly paralyzed. There is long neck with sloping shoulder, usually due to problem is with this scalene muscle as well. So this may be associated with these sorts of problems as well. There is cyanosis and coolness of the finger because the autonomic nervous system of C8T1 are also affected. There is increased sweating and unilateral Raynaud's phenomena, especially associated with the Raynaud's of the that is contraction, especially due to cold and blueness and numbness of the fingers of the ulnar side.